Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Chit Chat with Tim and Kurt.
Deep cut.
Games and chill. With Tim and Kurt.
Did you fuck that up or was that intentional?
I might have fucked it up.
With a couple of shots.
Oh, look at that. Neversoft.
That is, let's be fair, one of the best.
That is absolutely fucking gorgeous, seeing the old Neversoft logo there.
What else did they do other than Tony Hawk's and the game that we're going to play today?
Tony Hawk's 2. They
Good.
Did.
well,
what did they do?
It's pretty obvious now. What we're playing. We are playing.
Surprise. We are playing Spiderman.
What a game.
Like, now, Spiderman does whatever a spider can. Fucks his mum. In the bum.
Nope.
No, that's wrong.
God, just got it right.
It has. What now, this game, I was listening to, I think it was Podcast Beyond, IGN recently, and they spoke about this, and they were like, oh, you know, it was the first good 3D Spider-Man game. Well, they said the first 3D Spider-Man game, but they mocked it a little bit, Kurt, for the fact that the web never sticks to a building.
Yeah.
Now, I'm not going to lie, Kurt. As a fucking teenager, young teenager, I didn't give a solitary fuck about that.
It doesn't happen in Lego either.
I was happy as... you cannot imagine how fucking happy I was to be playing an actual Spider-Man game where everything just worked.
Yeah.
Where you were just web-swinging in 3D,
yeah, 3D
and taking out these generic skinhead Nazi thugs.
Yes.
Right, so we're going to get past the old...
It's such a good game.
Fuck the demo. It's a great game, and it has one of the most insanely hard bosses at the end of the game. Now,
just the music. It just takes you back, you know. And it's, I love those menus as well. Back in the PS1 and PS2 era, where it had like a really bad iteration of the controller.
Now I don't know if you can invert. I think it's too early.
Probably
to
not
invert.
Because it's probably for.
Oh, I love. That spider that you can see in the top right there, that was when you chose kid mode.
It is.
I can remember because he goes, kid mode!
Kid
which
mode
we'll see
controls.
In a minute. Right, so you can't invert or anything, so...
So you have to just play it like everybody else.
But that's a pointing, then. okay, so back... Now,
curse.
Just very quickly, special, there's going to be nothing in here. I mean, we could put cheats in, but none of us had the foresight to...
Nope.
Look for any cheats, but this game,
yes,
you could unlock. And yes. I know a lot of Spider-Man fans are against the Clone Saga.
Okay,
I'm not. I fucking adore the Clone Saga. It's one of my favourite Spider-Man stories. And you had the Scarlet Spider.
Yeah,
Ben Reilly, Peter Parker clone, or is he? Who knows. Fucking Scarlet Spider is the best Spider-Man costume that has ever existed. It was 90s as fuck, don't get me wrong. It was very much of the time. But the fact that you could unlock that in this game, I remember as a kid finding that out, and I was just like,
well, this is what brings it back to me with this game. It reminds me of, you know, you play the latest Batman game, and there's tons of unlockable stuff.
Mm.
And this game came out like 16 years ago, and it was It had all of that stuff, and I think it's just overlooked a lot of the time.
You ready to hear kid mode?
Yes.
Kid mode! Kid mode!
What are we going to play it
kid
on
mode.
Then, Tim? Are we
going
to
play it on
normal,
because we're
gonna
men.
Are we going to play it on Matt Wilson level, or are we going to play it on normal?
We're playing Matt Wilson Evil Within. What's the game? It is Evil Within, isn't it?
Yes, there's some deep cuts in this that was mentioned in Tim's podcast he does with his friend Matt.
Chit Chat with Tim and Easy Matt.
Easy Matt. Easy Platt.
Oh! Talking about Easy Platt.
PS1 game though, so probably
Hitman.
Yeah, all right. Someone's listened to...
I haven't.
Oh. Well, it's on... They talk about that one.
You know what I'm going to do?
Yes, I love you. You're going to sit through with a walkthrough and...
Fuck yes, I am.
You have so much time on your
hands. I've played it through on the... fucking PlayStation already. PlayStation, iPhone.
It's a great game.
It's a brilliant game.
Really good, and it's perfect for the Vita.
So I'm just going to sit there with a, hey, how do I just do these levels quick as fuck, get me a platinum. Boom!
Because that's what it's about. Games are about platinums.
Games are about platinums. I couldn't have said it better myself. Look at Peter Parker in that, surrounded by...
Dolph Lundgren in this Spider-Man game. That is...
There's Brock Lesnar.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Now, if I remember correctly, I think this was the first Spider-Man game that had Bruce Campbell as your tutorial. Spider-Man? Last time I checked, I was Spider-Man. Everyone's
Spider-Man.
Now, Kurt.
Yes.
Batman is obviously one of our favourite superheroes of all time.
The best.
And a lot of that is due to Christopher Nolan's phenomenal Dark Knight
trilogy.
Now, I think, and I'm guilty of this, I think Spider-Man gets overlooked so much. Spider-Man, he was one of the first comics that I got into seriously as a kid. And then I'm not going to lie, as soon as I look at him running away with that fucking massive thing just over his shoulder, massive bag of swag.
Superhero strength. Did he just call him Brock?
Yes, Brock. It's he's the guy that first comes under the Venom symbiote.
Brock Lesnar, mate. It's so canon. Yeah, so Spider-Man, yeah, I mean...
as soon as I discovered... There we go, Venom. As soon as I discovered X-Men and Batman and stuff, I just sort of like forgot about Spider-Man. But Spider-Man has had some fucking good comics. Like, I hadn't read any for absolutely years, and then they brought out a series called Superior Spider-Man.
I've heard of this.
Which, spoilers.
Nope.
was set, there's Carnage. Ladding it up in Doc Ock.
See, there's the cutscene. Opening cutscene. This game knows what the fuck is up.
It is giving you multiple things to deal with.
It's giving you a narrative. It's giving you something to work for. And I'm just bringing back so many memories.
Mm. Oh, yeah, because that was their whole reasoning for why you couldn't go down to street level. There's fucking neurotoxin everywhere. Yeah.
Genius.
Oh yeah, no, it's great, and it does, because obviously, yeah, PS1, you're not going to get down to street level, you're not going to get the draw distance that you get in like GTA, but...
I love these as well.
Yes, son. Tell you what, these fucking comic covers were banging.
Reminds me of the, did you ever play SmackDown 2?
Many, many years.
And all of the loading screens was a wrestler.
Yeah.
Just to stare at all, you know, the Lita one and stuff. It was just to stare at it like, boom. Being the child that I was.
Not Bruce Campbell. Stan Lee.
Bruce Campbell, then.
It must have been Spider-Man 2. Or the... Because they did... What was it? Revenge of Electro or something. They did a sequel to this game, which I never ever played.
I never even knew that that was a thing.
Yeah, they did a PS1 sequel.
Look at the graphics.
Oh, yeah. This was...
Sprawling...
Fucking Black Cat, son!
What's going on? Massive boobs. I know there's been some trouble, but the bank's being
robbed. And they've got hostages. Wow. That ass. That ass. Thanks, Kat. Oh, you know what the best thing about this is, Kurt?
What's that?
It's got a fucking analog control, son.
Yeah.
I tell you what, a PS1 game that has analog control, and I will make love to you hard.
Camera that can move Spider-Man. 360. I know it's not.
Oh, that ass. Close enough, you can swing to it. That's like two perfect blueberries.
Well, it was the polygon era, mate. Those are two fucking polygons right there.
Can you move the? You can't move the camera around. Well, with the analog stick, anyway. I think it's one of those things where it's. You can do the golden eye.
Yeah. Scope thing.
Specific aiming.
Well, that's okay. I mean, it's intuitive, isn't it? I love that sign. Just that.
That one, New York. New York.
Bit limbo that one, isn't it? With the hotel sign in Limbo. I've been playing Limbo recently, Tim.
Yeah?
Yeah. It's terrifying.
Now, you said just before... I thought there was a... Nope. Yeah.
riveting Let's Play so far.
Just before we started, you said you were going to surprise me. Spider sense is tingling.
I've been playing.
You said you were going to surprise me with something.
I've been playing quite a little bit this past week or so, Tim. I've been playing quite a bit of my Vita.
Lovely.
I love my Vita, and I have chronically underused it because there are, contrary to popular belief, so many games.
Too many games.
Never. So last week I completed, well, sort of. It's one of those games where you can complete it multiple times based on different things, doing different things with different characters. But Muramasa Rebirth.
Ooh, yes.
Which is stunning on the Vita.
Now, I've never...
Beautiful art style, great gameplay. Basically, all you do in that game is hack and slash using square.
Yeah.
But it's so much fun. And you can upgrade your swords, and there's a bit of depth to the, you know, the binding of the swords and stuff like that. But generally, you're just slashing and trying to use the most powerful sword. Well, that's what I did anyway. But it's a good little game, and it was free on PS Plus at some point last year. So if you picked it up and you put it to your library or something, then
yeah, I've only ever played a really little bit of it. But I mean, it looked fucking insanely stunning. It look nuts.
It's just a perfect Vita game. It's not got too much going on, so it doesn't struggle with frame rate or anything like that.
Yeah.
It's got great gameplay. It's like a side scroller that's got different areas, and you still have like a map where you can go back and forth and up and down to different areas, but it's sort of very 2D. It's very simple. Yeah, it's really good.
Oh. Who saw me?
I've also been playing, Tim.
Is this the one that's going to blow my socks off?
I don't think I'm going to blow your socks off. Don't oversell it.
Don't oversell it.
I'm almost near the end of Tearaway.
What?
A game that you bought me a year ago.
many moons ago, I bought you Tearaway.
A year ago.
I adore Tearaway.
It's so unique. There's nothing like it.
Oh, dude. First time you press the back touchpad,
yeah.
And your finger pops through.
Yeah.
For a minute, I was genuinely like, how do they know what my finger looks like?
Yeah.
And then I was like, oh no, it's just a generic finger. But I was so blown away by your finger popping through the back of the touchpad on the Vita. Oh, my
days. It like when the first people to watch a movie on a screen, and there's that train coming towards them, and they crash into them, just Tim there with his Vita shitting himself. Where does the web go, Tim?
You see, that's the thing, man. Like I said, that never, ever, ever bothered me. And right. I think because it is a product
like
of the time. Yeah, I mean, you could raise that complaint against the Spider-Man games that were on the Mega Drive or on the SNES. So you could say, oh, but they weren't attached to buildings.
No.
It doesn't matter. The fact that I am web-slinging for a 3D environment is fucking incredible.
It's badass.
It's so good. Now, we have just both played Firewatch.
We have.
Fantastic. What were your thoughts?
I thought it was great. It was stunning. The sort of colours in that game were just so pretty.
Oh, yeah.
And the subtle way that it goes from like a beautiful day to a overcast day to
blame for that too.
And then, we won't spoil anything, but it's... Yes, it's just careful, so Spider. Pretty, but off armed robbers on you have to go in with the expectation of what you're going to get out of it. You're not going to get a AAA experience. It's not that kind of game, is it?
It's a game that's like experimenting
unique,
and
I don't know if you. I think you did, but anyone I've spoken to that's played the game did it in one sitting. And I love games like that because I lost myself.
Oh yeah, you lose track of time so easily.
For those 4 hours, and it's one of those games, if you want to explore, you can. But you don't have to.
Yeah.
It's entirely up to you. I wouldn't say that it was massively rewarding to explore. It's not one of those games that's full of Easter eggs and hidden things. It's the odd thing, I think, here and there, but... If you don't want to go off of the beaten path, you don't have to. don't think it's expected of you. Did you find any like sort of hidden things?
I mean, I found things that were presumably optional. Like you can find the sort of like little tortoise.
I didn't find anything like that.
I mean, that's the thing, yeah. Like, it wasn't imperative for the narrative to continue that you find the tortoise. But I found the tortoise, and there's like a cute little interchange between you and who's the woman's name? Who's in Delilah. The other watchtower?
Delilah.
Is it Delilah? Okay.
I think so.
Input name. Should we put it as ruins? Spelled correctly.
Yeah. Yeah. Bit of admin. Because yeah. I've had so many ads since
so many.
So many ads.
I have so many admins.
One. So it's R.
U.
U.
I.
No.
No.
Backspace. What are you doing?
I'm backspacing, son.
R.
Yes.
U.
Yes.
Ready. U. I. N.
N.
S.
Baller, mate.
And I think that is me.
And if anyone wants
yes,
to get...
Yes, that's me.
If anyone wants to get a hold of Kurt on Twitter... That's the rabbit hole to dive down.
It is at first. I'm not sure anyone needs to
at
know that.
Ruins. Anymore. Save complete. Press any
and
button.
What is yours, Tim? Your really long.
At Timmy Garrett, 40k.
Two M's.
Yeah, Timmy.
Two R's, two T's.
Yep. All the doubles.
40k.
Everywhere there could be a double letter.
Not your email address. Which is ridiculous. I can't believe you haven't just set one up for the pod, to be honest.
Yeah, I keep thinking that, and then I'm like, oh, but then what if someone, as unlikely as it is, goes back and was like, I want to start listening to the first episodes of the podcast.
Oh, that's so good.
See, that was cool as well, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
He says, well, he fucking just can't climb anywhere.
The only... I wouldn't say negative, but the only things I would have to say about Firewatch is there's not an awful lot of narrative told through the things that you find. The narrative is very, very much the interactions that you have with Delilah.
Yeah, so I mean, my personal takeaway from Firewatch is I really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
I thought it was a really fun game.
Yeah.
My personal takeaway is that, and again, this isn't going into sort of spoilers or anything, I would have really liked for it to have continued as like the first hour did.
Yeah.
I thought it was more interesting, you know, it gets a little bit almost sort of like conspiracy theory-ish towards the end.
Yeah.
I don't think that was needed to make a fucking amazing game. I think the first hour of that game, the first couple of hours, are amazing, and I would have happily had it gone on just about the relationship between Hank and Delilah.
With the added eeriness of the environment.
Yeah, I mean, the environment was eerie enough without other stuff.
Yeah, and it's sort of the way it ramped up and built up to its sort of its climax or whatever. It sort of, yeah, you were left a little bit like, but this started out like so good,
yeah,
so well. Looks I was like so invested in this world and this weird, you know, sort of a slight Twin Peaksy vibe to it, a slight what was the other thing, just something where strange things are happening.
Yeah,
it's very remote, there's no one else there. You sort of kept you keep already seeing people in the distance, don't you?
Yeah.
You never actually.
Yeah.
You
come across anyone, they are
just as far.
They're out of reach. They're silhouettes. They're on an island, or they're too far away for you to actually deal with.
Yeah.
Which now, Kurt, fantastic. I'm gonna drop some lore on you.
Ooh.
Now, some people. Some people commented on our last video saying, hey,
did they?
Well, people that we know commented to me.
Oh, okay.
Saying, and I think I mentioned it to you, saying, hey, the audio, and I noticed it as well when I uploaded it. I think I put it in the description of the video. They said, the audio is a little bit tinny and Kurt sounds a little bit distant.
Hi.
After a little bit of jiggery pokery,
yes.
I figured out why that is, Kurt.
Why?
This £100, and for those American listeners, that's not the weight, that's the cost.
American
of, yeah.
Watches.
Watches. This £100 Blue Yeti microphone that I bought wasn't turned on. And we were actually recording all of our audio through the MacBook, which is why I sounded sort of fine, if a bit tinny, because I'm sitting nearest the MacBook.
A bit timmy. That's amazing, though.
And why you sounded a bit distant, because you're sitting further away from it. Going down. Spider-Man wow. taking elevators. Why the fuck?
It could have been worse, man, because remember when we finished and you thought you hadn't pressed record?
That is true. That's another thing.
Or you'd lost the file. So, yeah, it's still quite a fresh thing, still quite a new thing. There's going to be, you know, teething problems along the way.
Oh, yeah, without
it sounded doubt. Okay. It was perfectly acceptable.
Your standards are low, though.
Come on.
I'll leave that one right now.
You've
so, yeah.
got the funny, comic-y voice, Spidey.
Oh, they've got everything. I am going to... Now, Kurt.
Yes.
I am, A, going to recommend something... Oh no! You fucking killed the hostage.
Evil.
I'm sorry. I feel like I've let us down. Sorry. I would like to point out, I've had a lot of alcohol.
Yeah. As when I arrived, it was quite interesting.
In case my slurriness hasn't given it away.
When you're constant swearing.
Now, Kurt.
Tim.
I'm going to give you a recommendation. And also, at the same time as giving you a recommendation, just keep your eyes. I want you to also download it. Can you download stuff?
Tell me what it is.
Oh, mother fucker! There's people everywhere, Kurt. Basically. For people who are fans of... radio dramatizations.
Okay. You.
Me and old people.
People from the 1950s.
There is a, and I believe they're British, there is a radio dramatization group who put out fucking, no, they put out banging radio dramatizations of various sort of like pop culture geeky sort of like ting.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
And
just waiting for you there.
Oh, and they are called Dirk Mags. I believe their breakthrough thing was the original radio dramatization of Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
Hmm.
Now there is a way to scooch straight up. It might be something as simple as just looking up.
Yeah.
Nope.
What about on the actual wall?
There we go.
Yeah,
they made their name with Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, which is the radio dramatization of that is fucking timeless, perfect, amazing, biddly bonk. They've also done a few other ones. They did Judge Dredd, and Judge Dredd, The Day the Lord Dies, is, for me, personally, that is the definitive Judge Dredd. Like, you know, I like the new Dredd film.
Who am I to judge?
Oh, yeah.
Dredd.
Sorry,
I don't know what's happening. I've done a couple of those. Okay. So.
And the Judge Dredd one is fucking amazing. Really, really good. And up until a little while ago, you could listen to the whole thing on, you know, whole 3 hours or whatever it was on YouTube.
Yeah.
And it's fucking great. It is really good.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, you can lift things.
Throw a...
And walk really quickly. Come on, mate.
Look at his legs.
Some of this. Look at his legs.
Again, just a little weight. Wow.
Classic miss.
Great.
So
how's this handling, you know, after 16 years of...
I'm going to be honest, mate. It handles absolutely fine.
Do you wish that you had that camera tethered to the second?
Yeah, I mean, like, I do keep pressing the analog stick to try and
to reset,
orientate the old camera. But to be honest, I am not, the fact that it automatically orientates behind Spider-Man, which most of the time is where you want it to be.
Well, you know, we'd all moved on from, I think, tank controls from this point.
Yeah,
but it reminds me of how bad the camera was in Spyro, the first Spyro game. Remember that? The camera sort of just was never quite where you wanted it to be.
Well, you could move it with the L1 and R1.
You could, but it was just always off. Because I've downloaded it on my Vita.
Right, mate.
And I love that game. It's great. The music, the sounds. Fantastic game. Do you enjoy that?
Do you... What?
Bit of Spyro?
I love Spyro, mate.
Bit of Crash?
Not as much. No, now you're getting silly.
Crash is a great game. Classic.
You are really testing my patience.
Crash playthrough, speed run.
There will be a Crash playthrough, sir. Don't you worry. There will be. Whether it's you or the wife, there will be a Crash playthrough, because then you will be admitting, you'll be all like, oh no, actually, you're right, Tim. Crash is shite.
But Crash is coming back. Have you seen the rumours?
Yeah, and they were just stupid rumours. Like,
what is it that people keep seeing on Facebook is...
Hocus Pocus, Hocus fucking Pocus 2. There was another one. My friend Lindsay, who I saw today, she was mentioning...
What are you doing, Tim? You're running around.
I don't know.
You're running around like in Magus. There it is. There we go.
Big safe. Big safe. Let's get these gold bars. Can I pick them up? No.
I'm going to go on a limb and say no. Okay, so you've come in here. What's
Is there a vent I can go through? Just shuffle around.
Maybe you have to press the other one.
I'm going
to
try that. There we go.
Start the timer on the bomb.
Start the timer on the bomb.
Get the fucking bomb.
2 minutes. Two minutes to wreck.
2 minutes
some serious
one
shit.
1 second. Did you see?
Oh, nothing.
It's ironic, really, that you're in more danger of dying in this Spider-Man game than you were in Majors the entire way through.
What can I do about the bomb? Tell me, question mark.
Pick objects up, mate.
I can't remember what I need to do.
Put it in the safe and lock the safe.
Oh, that's it. Kurt, mate.
Really quickly.
You know, quite often.
Yeah.
Of a morning.
Yeah.
You know, your girlfriend Charlotte will sometimes roll over and wipe away whatever from last night is on her and just go, you know what, Tim? Sometimes Kurt doesn't know how to get rid of a bomb. And I'll say, you're not giving him enough credit, Charlotte. If you spent more time there and less time here...
Yeah. Very good.
Maybe... Very good. Maybe you'd appreciate him for the bomb defusal.
There we go.
Bomb defusal.
Bomb defusal.
Expert. He is!
Now, do you remember the game? Do you remember the days, Tim, when you used to play before having a memory card?
Well, no, because I always had a memory card.
See, I didn't.
If you look, for those of us, those of you...
Didn't all grow up in the vicarage, right?
For those of you at home, I'm directing Kurt by my television. There is a Ghostbusters original fire station.
Yeah, all right.
And if you look in the top window of the fire station, Kurt, you will see my grey PS1 memory card with a Final Fantasy VIII sticker adorning the front.
Very good. What?
That's how I rolled. Look at that cover! The Sting of the Scorpion. J. Jonah Jameson getting wrecked. Oh, cutscene. Now.
His hair. Amazing.
Scorpion was never, ever, ever one of my favourite Spider-Man villains.
No?
But I love his design in this. I like the dark green,
the
dark blue.
The whole design of it.
Just looks a bit more badass.
the cartoony vibe was so spot on in this time, because it made making the game a lot easier. They didn't have to try and make it super realistic. It wasn't,
yeah,
it wasn't something that, that they were able to do at the time. So being able to, and I think the costume as well is something that was much easier to make.
Now I've got to race him.
Better out,
that's
then.
What that. But is pretty far away.
I jump forward and this reminds me of another game, Tim, that we played together, that we might do a let's play of perhaps one day.
Majors.
X-Men Mutant Academy.
Oh, Mutant Academy.
Belter.
Now, was that Neversoft?
Possibly.
Because I know
maybe they had the license back then.
Yeah, because so they were all over the old Tony Hawks, weren't they, at the time? Wolverine,
Activision,
Spider-Man.
Obviously linked together with them as well. Definitely.
Just web swing past them. Go fuck yourself. Oh!
Good.
Oh, fuck.
Did you do that or did he shoot you?
I did that.
Oh, I see.
That was me fucking up like a pro.
Yeah. Because you're just so... You're so...
Come on. Come on! Focused. Taste my fist!
Away, what are you doing?
Look out.
Kill me.
I don't know where I'm going. Presumably, I want to head towards the old. Oh, fuck me sideways. Swing. No. Into the pit of despair we go.
Sorry, guys. This was supposed to be a sort of.
A complete let's play of Spider-Man.
A good sort of iteration of this game, but we keep dying. It's just so tough on normal. I have to bump it down to easy.
Bump it down to Wilson.
To Fetty Matt Wilson.
Oh, Spider-Man! Fucking Stan Lee!
Oh, you bought me Battlefield Hardline for
I did.
My birthday.
Have you played it yet?
I've played the first three episodes.
Oh, have you?
It's really fun. Really, really fun.
Because you never,
I never
mentioned that you wanted to play it.
I basically mentioned it every time you came over, and
now I think there was a way.
It's really good, mate. Honestly.
I believe you.
It's really solid, you know, just those EA DICE games, they just look stunning and just play solidly. It's a good sort of 7-8 hour romp and then you just move on. It's like playing a cop detective show.
Yeah.
This is really good. Really
bad
good.
Boys, bad boys.
Yeah.
What you gonna do?
But you're a sort of, our friend TJ.
TJ!
Who obviously will be watching this.
He loves it. He can't get enough.
Yeah. Sort of you play like a Hispanic guy and your partner is an Asian woman. That sort of ticking boxes. But it's absolutely fine.
Speaking of Asian women.
yeah.
I can't remember. Were you at HMV?
For 5 years, yeah.
There was a little Thai girl. Do you remember that? Do you remember her? I can't remember her name. Do you remember her?
No.
She might have come in. Oh, was it? No, she must have been there when you were there.
I'm going to need more than that, mate. I've got to be honest.
I can't remember. I swear she was there when you were there.
Two lights on.
But she was.
No one else home.
I went back to my college today to do a little. You could say a let's play of my life. to tell them about how uni is and whatnot. That's a bugle. And I'm going to grab that health. And there was a Thai girl there who really reminded me of this fine piece of ass that was a temp at HMV for a while. Okay. And I just thought you'd work with her.
So vague. You're just so vague, mate.
Yeah, because there were so many Thai girls that worked at HMV.
His hair, that is incredible.
It's a new millennium!
I do like that meme with the guy who played him in the movie. You know, where it's like, it's him laid back in his chair and then he does that sort of laughter.
Yeah, yeah.
So funny.
With J. Jonah Jameson talking about the new millennium, that's kind of reminding me a little bit of... Going back, now I'm playing through Digimon Story Cyber Sleuth.
You're absolutely rinsing those battles. Moments. Was it the trophy for 1,000 battles?
Yeah.
Popped that, bad boy.
But I went back to...
Boss fight.
I went back to watch some episodes of Digimon. And what I quite like is that Digimon used to sort of, you know, sort of like pride itself on the fact that it was like, you know, it dealt with stuff like the internet. It dealt with like modern technologies. And the first episode, I think it's Izzy, is at this like holiday summer camp trying to get internet connection. And he mentions about how his infrared internet connection is getting havoc. Now, I can't remember if
what are you doing?
I think, here we go, can wind him up.
Okay, yeah, carry on. Hello, mate.
Oh, hello. That took my life down.
Theatrical fall, wasn't it?
Now, there's no... Can I?
You
I can do that.
Aren't going to be able to get hit anymore.
Ooh, fuck a duck.
So not doesn't look like the most solid boss fight. It's a bit clunky and a little bit sort of. You seem to be
dead
quite far away because it's like you're not sure of the distance.
Yeah.
The distance of your punches. Anyway. Continue while you try and bimble your way.
And it was just, it just made me laugh because, like, it obviously at the time it was very cutting edge what they were talking about, but
it isn't anymore.
Yeah, now it's just sort of like, you know, fucking infrared connection. Are you kidding me?
Yeah, it was.
No, that's dial-up, mate.
I need to use the phone.
Infrared was just fucking. That was what some mobile phones had.
Was it?
Yeah.
I never did WAP. I went straight to.
Straight to wireless.
Well, I had an iPhone 3, mate.
You couldn't all live in a vicarage, mate.
Hey? This is true, eh?
Bringing it back.
Oh,
look, mate, I'm smashing it in the dick! Oh.
Smooth.
You just said, where are you? Oh, fuck off. Cheap shots. Cheap shots fired.
Get away, hit him with your web, and then we're going to hit him. Oh, no, the drill. I was going to say something, Tim.
Yeah?
I've just gone.
Hit me.
Do you want me to hit you?
Not literally.
Kill me. Mate, first boss.
JJ's off. JJ's out the door.
Yeah.
He didn't give a fuck.
So did he call you Peter?
No.
Are you sure?
I'd be out of a job if he called me Peter.
It is you, Peter. So what were your thoughts, Tim, on Spider-Man movies?
Oh, Spider-Man movies. Right.
First of all, how badass was the original cartoon?
Ah, oh, well, by original, do you mean the 90s cartoon, or do you mean
the one
that all the memes are on now?
Cover of this game.
It was fucking amazing, and it was phenomenal.
That's
because
how
it
I
was,
got into Spider-Man. I didn't read the comics or anything. It wasn't through that. I didn't really read that many comics when I was a kid. I sort of got more into that.
Well,
yeah,
the comics
and graphic novels as I've got a bit older, but. Cartoons. I watched, you know, the X-Men cartoon.
Yeah.
Spider-Man.
So I mean, that was the thing. The
Turtles cartoon was huge.
The Spider-Man and X-Men cartoons from the 90s were basically, you know, the Marvel Universe, cinematic universe that we've got now. It was full of crossover, full of fan service. Like, it was fucking. Oh, fucking Daredevil's in it! Get Matt Murdock up in your grill.
Get a state of his suit there.
Daredevil! Breakfast!
Listen,
it's true. A Spider-Man made off with Octavius' new invention, but not the Spider-Man, not me.
Everyone's
somebody's
in this bad boy.
Why? I don't know yet. And if New York's
voice acting,
yeah, the original
perfect voices.
The original 90s Spider-Man, which had the Spider-Man, radioactive Spider-Man. That was fucking amazing. That was fucking great. It had overarching stories. And like X-Men, it was just like, it was the comics brought to life, which at that age was all I ever wanted.
Yeah.
The films, absolutely loved the first one when I originally saw it as a kid, and then going back and watching it as an adult, and especially after other things like X-Men, X2 and stuff like that, it was sort of like, oh, this is a bit camp and a bit.
It came out, didn't it, when before it changed, before the landscape changed, and everyone was into comic.
Yeah, I think X-Men, I think, came out first.
Yeah. What a movie.
And then Spider-Man came out very soon after that.
Yeah.
But I mean, even I was literally chatting to my brother about this today. Oh, fuck a duck. What's going on? As controversial as it may seem, my brother texted me saying, like, oh, I've just watched X-Men 3, The Last Stand, for the first time since the cinema.
Go on.
And he said, it's not as bad as I remember. And I texted him back and said, Dom, fuck me, my health, what's going on? And I said, Dom, as controversial as it may seem, I would go as far as saying I probably now, because I only recently watched it for the first time after seeing the cinema. And I was like, mad skills. And I was like, I would go as far as to say I probably prefer. I probably prefer X.
That was not worth it.
X-Men 3.
No way.
To.
Yeah.
X-Men 1.
I thought the third movie was great.
I hated it when I saw it at the cinema.
It's really strange. You know when you watch movies in a particular frame of mind and they do something for you depending on how you're feeling? So. I watched X-Men 3 on a Sunday, tired as fuck. It was warm and cozy in my house, and I watched it with one of my old mates. And it was fucking great. It was really, really, really good. But I think all three of the X-Men movies are actually absolutely fine. There's nothing wrong with them.
I
prefer them to the newer ones.
Fucking hell, this is not going well for Spidey.
It's because you're trying to concentrate and talk at the same time.
I'm ignoring you, to be honest.
Oh, okay. Never mind. I thought they were fine. I think the more recent X-Men movies are okay. But they're not...
Your man.
They're not incredible.
X-Men... Okay, so this is where I stand. X-Men 1, I view X-Men 1 in the same light that I view Spider-Man 1. I think it's a bit of a... Yeah, just a fun camp. Oh, fuck my dick. A bit of a fun sort of camp. See, I swear there's a way that I can, like, web sling up ting. There we go. A bit of just, fun campness. X-Men 2, I still think, is one of the best comic book films. And by comic book, I mean it feels like a comic book. It feels like that, just that camp comic booky. It feels like an X-Men comic book probably would if it was brought to cinema, completely unaltered sort of thing.
Yeah.
X-Men 3. Oh, fuck that. X-Men 3, like I said, I saw it at the cinema, and this was at, like, the height of me being into Marvel, and coming off X-Men 2, I was just like, well, this is only going to be the best thing fucking ever. Dick!
Checkpoint there, so...
And I saw it at the cinema, absolutely fucking hated it with a mad passion, and then it was only a few years ago, I watched it again for the first time, since watching it at the cinema, I was like, that's actually not as bad as I remember it. First Class, I think, is fucking incredible.
I really like First Class, but I don't know. I just thought that the original trilogy just cast so perfectly.
Yeah, but I think First Class was, like, cast pretty spot on.
No, I don't disagree. I liked Days of Future Past. I didn't think it was as.
I saw Days of Future Past at the cinema, and I was just like, really don't care for it. I think the best thing Days of Future Past had going for it was Quicksilver. Quicksilver was great, and he was much better than the Marvel cinematic.
And the scenes with him in was really good.
Yeah, really well done.
I just love...
Because, I mean, dude. Beginning of X-Men 2. Fucking, Nightcrawler in the White House. Fuck. That.
I need to watch that.
Like, that scene. Like, I saw that and Dark Knight Returns are the two films that I've only ever seen at the cinema twice in the same day.
Dark Knight Rises.
No, Rises is with Bane. Yeah, Dark Knight. Oh, it's just Dark Knight, isn't it?
It's the comic.
Dark Knight, yeah, Dark Knight Returns is the comic.
So I went to see the comic in the cinema.
But yeah, they're the only...
This is quite difficult, mate. It's difficult to spike. But look, it's mixing up the gameplay.
It is! It's mixing up, maybe a bit too much, but it's...
I like this game.
I like this game.
I think we should think of some more games to play through. I swear I've got some more PS1 games in the old loft.
Well, have a goosey gander.
You've got a few as well, haven't you?
Yeah, well, I mean, one game that I do really want to play but never ever did, and it is meant to be the best Spider-Man game of all fucking time, was Spider-Man 2 on the PS2. Never ever played it. My brother was absolutely fucking obsessed with it. Matt Wilson, I think, was absolutely obsessed with it.
You normally are prone to a good recommendation.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I mean, what I...
Just... Out of spite, just completely ignored it.
One game that I would love to... hey, where are you going, Spidey? One game that I would love to do a little, you know, if we're talking about fucking superhero ting, I just can't avoid that. That's just going across the whole building. Bit of health there, it's fine. Captain America on the PS3, the first Avenger, that game is really, really fucking good.
Absolutely, and
really fucking good.
We've discussed a few times, haven't we, is that this generation, there have been a few casualties, but one of the big ones seems to be
movie tie-ins.
There's no tie-ins. There's no, like, you know, Captain America or...
It seems like the only tie-ins you get now are like sort of Lego
tie-ins, which are generic shooters, but they're just still sort of average campaigns to play through. You only ever seem to get now that there's the indie scene, which we both love, and then there's the triple A scene. Where's the middle ground? It doesn't even have to be the same as the movie. It doesn't have to have the movie's name. It can just be its own thing. You know, that Wolverine game.
Oh, that Wolverine game.
No one knows. That game is so brutal and fun and like mindless, violent fun.
Yeah, it's God of War.
But games
it's
like
God
that
of War
don't
comics.
Get made anymore. Do they?
No.
They don't get the time of day because they either don't make enough money or they're not part of this new...
Yeah, like, I miss that, man. Like, you know, I was saying, like...
There were so many games like that on the PS3.
What
so
was the...
Many.
Where the Wild Things Are. Where the Wild Things Are was a genuine fucking surprise at just how...
Because this was at the height of your...
Yeah, trophy hoard.
Boredom, wasn't it?
Just, yeah, running around trying to just get trophies. And I played that just to get an easy plat and ended up finding a friend, Kurt.
Exactly. And that's what I think is missing a little bit. I think there's the... There's less hidden gems.
Yeah.
This generation, for sure. And you know that's not necessarily a bad thing. It's
Did we do it?
No, it's very, very cinematic, very good. But yeah, I think there's something lost a bit. And I don't want the store to be full of shit games.
Yeah.
To the contrary, I want there to be, you know, still some quality control there. But there's place for everything. There's enough scope to have every type of game out there.
Kurt,
Tim.
Can I just say I'm fed up with this fucking helicopter now?
That's fine.
I've had enough of it.
Well, monsters infest sewers. Spider-Man can say he's had enough, but, you know, New York needs him.
And I'm pretty sure these guys in turquoise, they're the cops from the cutscene I wasn't paying attention massively to the cutscene earlier, but they looked like they were the.
I just like, you know, it's mixing up the top style of buildings. It's got. It doesn't really tell you.
What's going on?
What's going on? Why is this helicopter trying to kill you?
Police. My fucking police trying to keep a Spider-Man down.
That was a hefty punch.
Oh, a mad punch.
Mad school. Oh, rock song.
One of the things that I loved the most about the Neversoft Marvel partnership was, like we said, you could play as Spider-Man and Wolverine and Tony Hawk. And one of the things that I think gets a little bit overlooked,
yes,
when talking about Tony Hawk is unlocking the different decks. Now, you didn't get anything extra from unlocking decks. It was purely aesthetic. But when you had the Spider-Man and Wolverine,
thing is over, mate.
When you had the Spider-Man and Wolverine decks, they were like the, you know, like we've seen the comic designs. They were like really fucking good, detailed comic book sort of decks that you got. And they were fucking awesome.
Tony Hawk's, man. One more step and it's a load of what we have to do to get a skating game on this generation?
Yeah.
I'm not counting that Tony Hawk's game.
Or, even though I know you didn't get, you know, addicted to it or anything. What was the fucking arcadey?
Ollie Ollie.
Yeah. It's fine. I know what you mean, though. You want a 3D arcadey. I mean, you know, this is how I feel with SSX, man. It's like, I want that. I just want that arcadey pick up and play. Fun game,
yeah,
and we just haven't had it.
Skate 2 for me was the best, because Skate 1 was a revelation. I remember when I got my 360, I got three games with that. I got that year's FIFA,
yeah,
Halo 3, Tony Hawk's 2,
yeah,
Halo 3, and Skate, and that did me for a fucking long time.
Oh yeah,
those games, and it was amazing. I think every games console generation should have at least one or two good skating games, because it's just so much fun.
Yeah,
to go around like this, the world Skate made, it was just so good. But I don't think EA are interested, are they?
No.
At the moment, like you said about, was it PewDiePie? Like, I did a Let's Play of Skate.
Well, this is what I'm.
And then it had to go back into.
This is what I'm hoping we get with Spider-Man. I'm hoping for the next few months we get a load of like prepubescent teens going into HMV and you got fucking Spider-Man. You got fucking Spider-Man on the fucking PS1, mate.
What was the game? The more recent, like, open world Spider-Man game, which was meant to be incredible, wasn't it?
The most recent one.
What was it they were talking about on Beyond? Not most recent necessarily, but like there was an open world.
Well, Spider-Man 2 was like
Spider-Man 2.
Yeah, that was PS1.
Oh,
PS2. Sorry, PS2. Yeah. They've done Spider-Man games. I've played through the tie-ins for the Amazing Spider-Man.
There's a Vita release for that.
Yeah, well, that's what I've got on the Vita, because I just thought it'd be a fun.
How is that?
It's fine. It probably, to be honest, playing this, it feels very similar to this. Like, it's not ideal 3D controls, but it's completely serviceable 3D controls.
Did you see that the,
Cat just got fucking rhinoed in the behinode.
Oh, that's nice. That the new Lego Marvel game is open world on Vita.
I did see.
That's awesome.
I did see that.
My fear is that if I play the open world Lego game, is that I will never want to go back to the level based ones. Hey, that is expensive equipment. Because they've said it's really constrictive.
Good luck.
To go back to the being restricted to levels and stuff. But then I suppose, you know, lots of platform games.
Fucking hell. well, you know, I'm speaking as someone who.
This game doesn't stop, does it? There's no.
It is the diehard.
You've been here every single time, by the way.
I missed first one. He didn't get me. Oh, I think I'm jumping into the electric. I think that's what the problem is. I think I need to stand a little bit. There we go. Speaking as someone who's playing through the LEGO games recently, I prefer the Vita LEGO games to the console ones, purely because, you know, I want to play through these games, and I want to play through them, you know, not as quickly as possible, but I want to play through them in a, I don't have the time, you know, I don't have the time to be playing 30, 40 hours to try and platinum a LEGO game.
Sat at your TV.
Yeah,
that makes sense. Also,
oh, I got dead.
Also,
and LEGO Batman 3, like I say this now, man, LEGO Batman 3 on the Vita is fucking amazing. It is so good. It is so fucking good. And I think, you know, all of them, all the LEGO games, or, you know, a good chunk of them, are only $14.99. Which, when you're thinking you're spending 20 hours on each one to platinum it or whatever, get through all
deep,
of it.
They're deep games, and they get it. They get what the collectionists, like the hunters, the trophy hunters, they, what they want. But also, the style of those games as well is perfect for the Vita, because it doesn't have to look realistic. Has to look colourful, and that OLED screen, baby.
That OLED screen, son.
Oh, Tim, I've ordered my Vita triggers.
You got your triggers.
Trigger, please. I've been waiting, mate. I've been waiting
for
months and months and months for these triggers. I don't think you understand how much it means to me.
So what are you planning on playing with these triggers?
FIFA benefits
from
yes,
from
because the
control.
Problem with the Vita remote play is, and I'm sure like Sony never said this, but they made a huge mistake. First of all, why haven't they released a first party peripheral that gives you these? If some Japanese company can make this thing third party, then Sony can make a fucking grip.
Yeah.
The R2 and L2 are on the back touchpad, and I don't know if you've ever tried to play a game like that, but for me it is virtually impossible.
Yeah, I tried to download
it's unbelievably hard.
I tried to download Metal, well no I tried to download I did download Metal Gear,
yeah,
the first one, Metal Gear Solid 1, and and yeah, I think you need the R2 and L2. Hey! What are you doing, Spider-Man?
It's almost dead, mate. Come on. How long do you think this game is?
Well, I have completed this game, which is sort of like a little claim to fame, because the Carnage Dr. Octopus final boss is an absolute bastard. And I remember me and my old friend Tim Green, who's now a superstar DJ, yeah, you know, it took us a whole evening. Oh, fuck me, he's not getting stuck into anything, is he? Whoa.
So because I think the remote play function is such an underrated part of the Vita.
Yeah.
Games look so nice on that. And like you say, when you haven't got time to sit for 8 hours or whatever in front of your actual TV, I can lie there with that remote play and just dick around with games on my Vita whilst my lady watches something on TV or something. It's going to be a game changer, mate.
Yeah. I mean, like I said, I tried to play Metal Gear Solid 1, you know, the PS1 version. Played it, obviously, before on PS... on the actual PS1.
Yeah, of course.
I've got Black Cat all tied up by those fucking gremlin men. And like, yeah, you need R2 and L2, I think, to cycle the weapons, and it works okay, but it is not reliable. It's not great. It's not good. Well, so yeah, triggers I can see.
It depends as well. It depends, first of all, let's just take an isolated example of a game that has a lot of buttons and a lot of controls. So FIFA. Now, R2 on FIFA is to run.
Yeah.
So you have to be able to use run.
Yeah.
And I've looked, and I've looked online as well. There's no way to map the buttons on FIFA. So I can't change the buttons.
Look how good Venom looks.
It looks amazing.
Look at those teeth.
So I can't change it. I've got no choice.
Yeah. That's my story,
but it... Like you're in a but lot this trouble. This grip is just I don't, I, it annoys me that Sony can't do it themselves. But this, like I said, random fighting. Company in Asia have to make this probably illegal third party grip.
Poor Spider-Man with his doesn't have any actual fingers on his gloves.
No.
Just got mitts.
Perfect voice. Did you think they used the same people from the cartoon, or was it?
I don't think it was.
No.
But coming back to Dirk Max.
Ooh, segue.
Coming back to Dirk Max. Like I said, they did Judge Dredd, they did Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
Oh, fucking hell, did we just go on a massive tangent for 20 minutes?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
They did.
Stark?
Yeah, lads. Stark Solutions.
Stark, living in the same world as Tony Hawk's 2. What a time to be alive. Yeah.
They did an absolutely fucking phenomenal Spider-Man radio drama.
Oh my god, was that what you were trying to get at that whole time?
Yeah, and I was just like... and it had Spider-Man in it. I lost Venom. Slowpoke. And so, because I lost Venom, that means he can turn invisible, obviously.
Yeah.
But it had the fuck me, man, it was incredible. But I've never been able to find it. I had all these things. That's the thing. I had all these things: Judge Dredd, Spider-Man, Superman. Superman they did release on CD, but all the Spider-Man and Judge Dredd, no CD release. So it's sort of like, well, how am I ever meant to? Oh fucking whim. How am I ever meant to, like, you know, listen to these again? So if you...
Pay for to watch.
If you, Kirk, could find Spider-Man and Judge Dredd, The Day the Law Died, by Dirk Max on whatever websites you use, Pornhub, ZooTube, whatever it is, however you get your kicks,
right,
that would be a favour. A favour. That would be, you know, I'm trying to save you money here. That would be my 30th birthday present done. That would be sort of.
Fair enough.
Good quality, though. Like, not like. Not like that.
A flack.
Yeah, not like that video that.
This is.
Where am I going?
I'm so sorry. This is pathetic. Basically, this is.
I'm going to level with you.
Come on.
I think. The amount I've had to
what
drink.
What was that? The Statue of Libby, just in the middle
just
of New
in the
York City.
Just in the middle. Yeah. Not on. What's the island it's on? Liberty Island. I'm gonna say Liberty
I think
Island.
It's Ellis Island.
Ellis Island sounds more.
See, I've had to be doing my homework on New York, Tim.
Yeah, because you're going to New York.
On Saturday.
Saturday.
It's alright, mate. You might be reaping the rewards of my visit soon. Keep moving. So. With your Islanders jersey.
Yes, Islanders jersey, son. I'm all about that Islanders jersey.
Well,
any ice hockey jersey.
Your wife has expressed.
Fuck her. She doesn't. She hasn't earned. She hasn't earned it.
Your lovely dinner.
Where are you going, Pete? Right. This way, is it? Don't know where I'm going.
You're there, mate.
I'm trying to follow the compass, but... Quit slacking, boy! Where are you going? Where are you going, Venom?
Now, is Venom...
Come on, Parker. Venom is the...
Supposed to be...
He's Eddie Brock. Oh, my
goodness! Yeah.
Went to cover... I think it was J. Jonah Jameson's son or relative... Coming back from space. From space! And they came back from space with this thing called the symbiote on their shuttle, which was a black tar alien symbiotic liquid. And because it feeds off like negative emotions, I think, and Eddie Brock was full of anger and hate for Pete Parker, because Pete is a much better...
You know what, mate?
I'm struggling. Pete was a much better...
He's a better
photographer work. And journalist and whatever it is.
Right,
that,
go right. There we go.
Whatever it is that he does. Ah! I don't think I even got a checkpoint. Did I get a checkpoint?
If you didn't, maybe it might be a good time to...
Okay, so that was Games and Chill.
I love that Statue of Liberty.
Yes, as always, chit chat with Tim and Matt, and also.
Oh, this is bad.
Put this up. At Timmy Garrett 40k, TimmyGarrett40k, for Twitter, and ButterBum40k, ButterBum40k at hotmail.com for emails, and.
So get it right this time.
Get it right this time.
Ruins, RUU. INS on the Twitter.
On that Twitter. So
let's
talk
about games. Let's talk about stuff. Have a great time.
So
let's not chase Venom to his hideout. Let's not.
Let's just have that scene again of you've lost Venom. There we go. Straight away. Although I think I've done well.
You have.
I think I've done alright.
For a game
considered.
you say you've beaten.
Have.
And you keep dying.
So yeah, thank you very, very much for joining us for this.
Do the kid mode again before we go.
Do the kid mode before I go. Kid mode. See, that's Green Goblin saying it, I think, or Carnage. I can't remember how the voices are. Kid mode.
Sounds like Matt Wilson.
Kid mode.
Kid mode.
Kid mode. That's the one I remember.
So is it different ones each time?
Yeah. Kid mode. That's just Jimmy Savile whispering it into your ear.
I love that there's a kid mode on this game.
Kid mode. Yeah, I think they just got every voice actor in the game to say kid mode.
Yeah, good. Let's...
Nothing. The amazing mute man said that one.
Kid mode. Okay.
Ooh. Okay, so thank you very much, everyone. Thank you for joining us. And obviously, like I said, Kurt is going to be away in the US of A very, very soon, like this week. So this will be uploaded before he goes. Like and comment if you want to. We will also have part two of mine and Victoria's Alundra playthrough up this week. And we will go into detail about how that has been an absolute fucking nightmare to try and record. Thank you very much. Also, keep an eye out and check out Relatively Retro Don's Battletoads Tunnel completion video. I don't think it's up yet. He posted a video with his sort of progress on it. Obviously, it's one of the most difficult things in gaming to do. And I think from what I can gather from his comments, he actually managed to do it. So keep your eyes peeled on Relatively Retro.
Good guy.
Don. And we will see you soon when Kurt gets back from New York with Tales of New York as we play through another PS1 classic. Thank you very much. And goodbye from me.
Bye.
And goodbye from Kurt.
Bye. Then his work. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.